What's going on, guys? Today I'll be building a railing for my loft.
Alright, guys, it is time to build a railing for the loft. And this has definitely been necessary. I probably should have done this right away, but I didn't, especially when you're riding bike up here, as you saw in my last video. You land up here, it's definitely pretty dangerous to just have this drop off with no railing. So that's what we'll be fixing today. I think I'm gonna just have the railing start here at the top of the steps. So it's gonna go out for, I think this is like 2 feet, and then it's gonna have to angle in, follow that platform, and then go straight back to the wall. And I'll be honest, I don't have an exact plan as to what I'm gonna do. I have an idea in my head. I'll be doing something pretty simple. I think I'm just gonna use 2x4s. Yeah, I could go crazy and do something super fancy, but I wanna save money on this project and I have a bunch of extra 2x4s laying around. The one thing I did plan is the hardware I'm gonna use. I have some carriage bolts here. So this is a 3.5-inch bolt. So that's gonna go out here at the stair landing, because that will go through one 2x4 and then this 2x10. So 3.5 inches will give me enough meat on the backside to attach the nut. And then the other one I have is 5 inches. And that's because on the long straight section here, it actually has to go through this double header. So it's gonna have to go through the outer 2x4 post and then through both headers and then have enough room for the nut on the back. So like I said, I have a basic concept of what I want to do, but I'll figure out the details as I go. So let's get started. All right, guys, I've now got the railing complete. So I started off with placing each post, and that was using those carriage bolts I mentioned, tightened up nicely with the nuts on the backside, and everything was the correct length, so I didn't screw up my math anywhere. So I have 5 vertical posts total, and the placement was based off a few things. I had to keep in mind that I had 8-foot 2x4s, so I couldn't have any span being greater than 8 feet. I also had to keep in mind where my floor joists were so that I could have enough room on the backside here to have my bolt come through and place the nut on the back. So I had to make sure I didn't place one right on a floor joist because then I would run into either the joist or the joist hanger. So you can see how I spaced that one off a little bit so I had enough room for the nut. And then also just the shape of the loft, having this landing, this little extra piece I added, I kind of just needed to have these 3 posts where they're at, so then I could match the shape of the landing with the railing. So then once I had all of my posts set, I started with this top 2x3. So I used some 2x3s here because A, I had a lot of them, and B, it really wasn't necessary to use a 2x4 for everything. So I attached this top 2x3 first, and that tied all of the posts together, really fix them in position. And then basically the same exact thing for the middle 2x3. So I split the gap, so I have that one directly in the middle. I think I probably could add some more. I could split the gap again up here and down below, so I had 3 in there, just to increase the safety even more so you don't have any risk of slipping through. And here you can see how I attached these on the angle. It was kind of difficult to get this angle right. I knew that this was a 45 degree, so I cut all of these at 22.5 and this at 22.5, and then I held the last section in here and marked it to make sure that it would match, and that worked out pretty well. I had to do a little bit of sanding to get them both perfect. And then you can see here I drilled a pilot hole and a countersink so that I could put those 3-inch screws in without risk of cracking. And once I added both sets of 2x3s, it really did shore up the posts. Since they were then tied together, they flexed much less when pushing outward. Then the last thing I added was the top rail, and so this is a 2x4. You can see I added a little bit of an angle here at the beginning just so it's not a sharp edge as you're walking up the stairs. Also angled that 2x3. So this one just sits flat on top. It gives you a nice little ledge that you can lean on, and it really makes it just look a lot nicer than having just the end of the 2x3 sticking up. So then it was feeling pretty good, but it still flexed a little bit here in the long section, because when you're using a 2x4 in this orientation, it is a lot weaker. And that's because when you push out on this, the moment of inertia is much lower in that direction compared to if you had it flipped the other direction. But because of the way I was attaching it with the carriage bolts, I basically had to do it in that orientation. So then what I did is I added a 2x4 to the side of this middle post, as you can see. So that is in the stronger orientation. So that has a much higher moment of inertia. So when you now push out on this, it barely flexes at all. That shorted up so nice. And I did it just on this middle post. I could do it on all of them, but because these 3 are so close together, that makes it a lot stronger since they're all tied, and that really doesn't shake much at all. And then this last post, I actually attached to the structure of my building. So I just used some scrap 2x10 I had, and then I attached it right to the post of my building. And so that completely eliminated any shake from this side. This is the most solid section. And then that really transfers over to the rest of the structure. And I did space this last post off of the structure a little bit so that I could have some 3/4-inch plywood, because I think when I do go to insulate everything, I'll have the insulation obviously in here, and then I'll have the plywood on top of this post. So once that's in place, I will take that L bracket out and attach the last post directly to the plywood of the wall. And once I had the structure completed, I just did a little bit of sanding up here on the top rail because I want it to be nice and smooth. So if you run your hand along it, you won't catch anything. And like in this area is where I had to sand the most just because it was hard to get this to line up perfectly. And once the sanding was done, I went ahead and painted. And as you can see, I matched the outline that I have on everything else. So the outline of the stairs, the outline of the whole ramp, and the outline of the loft. And I think that looks pretty nice. It gives a little bit of a contrast from everything else surrounding it. So that is the completed handrail. I know it's not the most exciting thing we could be doing, but it was definitely necessary to make this a much safer space. And now I can really plan out what I want to do up here. And also if I'm riding bike up here, it's much less dangerous and I don't have to worry about falling off the edge. And don't worry, I do have plenty of things in mind for the Z3. Of course, everything with cars costs so much money, so I have to give it some time to save up so I can do what I really want with the car, but that'll be coming up soon. I also have some other plans for the Mustang, thinking about changing up the front end a little bit, cleaning up some things, and possibly changing the exhaust too. So definitely tell me if you'd like to see anything else on the channel, and let me know what you think of my new railing.